Alright, hey guys, what the hey here, and today we're going to be running my Nikko radio controlled Firehawk. I've actually owned this since 2006. It's very responsive, it's not infrared. It has great performance, and I don't know, it's missing the aerial as you can see, but it's actually in pretty good nick, so I'll just find the switch and turn it on. Alright, remote. Let's get going. A little bit of drip. You'll notice there's a dog, her name's Honey, she's not for sale. Oh, another drift. So yeah, this is very responsive. In most infrared cars, you'll notice when you steer and drive at the same time, you lose a bit of power, but that does not happen in the Firehawk. I don't know, should we do a bit of off-roading? This is actually the first time I've run this in months, because it's just been sitting on the shelf. You may have seen it in my previous videos, I don't know if you have or not. Maybe go back a few videos and you might see them while I've been doing my anniversary talks reviews. Bit of wheel spin there. Bit more wheel spin. Like I said, it's not infrared. Old style, I've owned it since 2006. Ran for quite a while. In great condition. It is also proportional, so it has different speeds, so I'll back it up a bit and I'll put it on a set speed. Alright, let's do this. As you can see. So yeah, it does have different channels. It's got two channels. It's also got suspension, it's got front wishbone suspension, well not really wishbone, it's got one rear suspension. It also does have a different It's also pretty good for off-roading. It does have a lot of power, and gusto, some people might call it. This is the first time, like I said, the first time I've run it in a while. I'm sitting on my shelf. Oh, I nearly hit the brick there. I'm gonna walk over here to get a better view. Alright. First of all, this has like at least, I don't know, 7 miles. This is what the remote looks like. It does have two channels. The front bumper is a bit wonky. Spoiler is in pretty good condition though. for a visit. I don't know, it might get hung up, it might not. I don't know. Okay. Seems to be losing a bit of power. The battery does drain quite fast, I don't know why. So it's kind of old. It's probably because the battery's old. I mean, I've only seen 2006, like I said, 2 times already. Like I said already, the dog is not for sale. Probably a pointless thing to say, but just in case, you know. For some reason, last time I ran this, when the battery was draining, for some reason had a mind of its own. I was not touching any knobs on the controller, and it was driving by itself. I have no idea why. Probably just because it's been a lot of play. Very old. I have no idea how old it is. It might be like at least 15, 16 years old. It's going on 20 at least. That's a bit unfortunate. Yeah, see, look at that. I'm not touching anything, it's driving by itself. Oh, that's a bit of a bummer. Battery's dying, I'm gonna end this video here, guys. If you enjoyed, be sure to drop a like and subscribe, and also, stay tuned, I might also make some more Firehawk videos, like off-roading, and I will see you guys in the next video.